Hi there, I'm Bob Eubanks. Can you answer this trivia question? Who will host this year's Academy Awards show? Well, you get the answer to that question and be challenged by many more on the all-new edition of Trivia Trap. Welcome to the fascinating world of trivia. Our senior team is ready. Playing for the seniors are Patricia Reed, Gary Jackson, and Judy Tyson. And our junior team is set. Playing for the juniors are Tom Clyde, Lori Schaefer, and Shirley Chen. And here's the host of Trivia Trap, Bob Eubanks. Thank you. Hello, everybody. Thank you very much. Welcome to Trivia Trap. We've got two new teams with us today. We said goodbye to our champions, the seniors, the other day. So let's welcome those who are under the age of 30. There are juniors here for the first time. If you've reached your 30th birthday in our show, you qualify as a senior. We have new seniors with us. Here they are. Okay, let's start our game right now. We will start with our fact or fiction round, which we always do. I'm going to give each one of our contestants a trivia statement. What they must do is tell me whether that statement is true or false. Remember, every correct answer is worth $25 for their team. So we tossed a coin before the show, and look who won the toss. It's the seniors. That means they get to choose first. So you tell me, Patricia, Gary, and Judy, will it be the red set or the black set of questions? Which ones?
We'll take the black.
The black set.
The red set then goes to our juniors, and we're off and running. Patricia, yes. First question, true or false? A drone is a bee whose only function is to mate with the queen bee.
False.
No, that's true.
Oh.
That's true. Heck of a job, huh? Gary. The technical word for the yolk of an egg is an albumen.
That's false.
Yes, it is false. You're right. That's the white of the egg. Hi, Judy.
Hi.
Judy, Marlon Brando's last feature film was Superman.
True.
Oh, that's false. The formula in 1980. You got one right. You've got $25. Let's go down to our juniors. They left you the red set of questions. All right. Here we go. Tom. The host for this year's Academy Awards show will be Jack Lemmon.
True.
Yes, it is true. Lori. Pia Sidora recently gave birth to a son.
False.
It was a girl. A little girl named Katie, in fact. Shirley. Yeah. The producers of the James Bond movies are seeking a new James Bond and have made an offer to Mel Gibson.
True.
Nope, that's false. All right, you got two out of three right. So you have $50 for their $25. And this time, juniors, you make the choice. Red set or black set?
Red.
Let's take red.
Red set, leaving the black set then for our seniors, and we'll go right back to you, Shirley.
Okay.
Here's your question. The lawyer who defended the Boston Strangler, I should say, was F. Lee Bailey.
False.
No, it's true. It's true. It was F. Lee Bailey. Lori, the planet Pluto was first discovered in 1930.
False.
No, it's true. 1930. No fair asking for help, Tom. Tom, in A Christmas Carol, the first ghost Scrooge saw was Christmas past.
False.
Yeah, Jacob Marley. All right. So you have $75. Over here to our seniors. Got to do some catching up. Judy, true or false? Eating a diet consisting of nothing but carrots will make your skin turn bright yellow.
True.
Yeah, it will. Isn't that fun? Gary, George Washington was inaugurated in the state of Virginia.
That's false.
Yes, it is, in New York. Chance to tie it up, Patricia. John Wayne's male co-star in True Grit was Glenn Campbell.
False.
No, it's true. It's true. So there you have it. $75 for the juniors, $75 for the seniors. We're going to pause with these words. When we come back, we're going to play our very exciting trivia trap round. We'll be back with that in a moment. Trivia Trap. Good game. Two new teams today, by the way. $75 for the juniors, $75 for the seniors. It's the team that makes it to $1,000 that wins the game and then goes on to play for a possible $10,000. And we're all tied up at 75 apiece. But our seniors won the toss of the coin before the show, so they get the choice. They get to pick the categories. And every question in this round, seniors, the first choice you must make, whether it be James Bond or Teddy Roosevelt.
James Bond.
You want James? You going to talk it over with the ladies,
James
Gary?
James Bond.
Okay.
James Bond or Teddy
James
Roosevelt?
Bond.
James Bond. All right, two out of three. Here we go. Leaving then Teddy Roosevelt for our juniors. Question goes to Patricia. Here it is. According to the James Bond novels, he was born in one of these cities. Was it Chichester, England, Tashkent, Russia, Wattenscheid, Germany, or Nairobi, Kenya?
In Germany.
Let me tell you first that the question's worth $50, $100, or $200, depending on how many of you agree on the right answer. You say the right answer is
Germany,
all right? Gary, do you agree or disagree with that?
I'm going to agree.
You agree with Wattenscheid, Germany. Judy?
I'll agree.
You also agree. All right. Hang on, you guys, because if you're right, all three of you are right, it'll mean $200 for your team. Good luck to you. Let's find out. Was James Bond born in Wattenscheid, Germany? Yeah. And there he was. His parents, by the way, were English, but his father was working in Germany when he was born, and they get $200 for that answer. So our seniors have $275. Let's go right to our juniors. Whew. Pressure's on, gang. They left you with a category of Teddy Roosevelt. And, Tom, the question goes to you. Okay. President Teddy Roosevelt hired an expert to teach him this while he was in the White House. What was it? Was it bird calls, jiu-jitsu, needlepoint, or Morse code? He hired an expert.
I'm going to say bird calls.
Bird calls. Let's see what Lori says. Agree or disagree, Lori?
I'm going to agree with him.
You agree with bird calls. Shirley, how do you feel about this one?
I'm going to disagree.
You disagree. You and the audience, anyway. $100 for your team if the correct answer is bird calls. Oh, it's not bird calls. Shirley, you disagreed. That means that you have to come up with the correct answer to save your team. Get $50. What will it be?
I'll take a guess and say needlepoint.
Needlepoint. Hey, you guys. Teddy Roosevelt and the Rough Riders, remember him? For $50, is it needlepoint? No. Jiu-jitsu, yeah, he was a tough guy. Okay, no money there. Let's go again. I've got two more categories for our seniors to choose. Chaplain or meat? Chaplain or meat?
Meat.
You want meat? Leaving chaplain then to our juniors. Question goes to Gary. Here it is. Prime is the highest grade of beef. What is the lowest beef grading? Is it standard, commercial, canner, selected?
I'm going to say standard.
Standard, you say. Judy, got a choice to make. You agree or disagree?
I disagree.
You disagree with standard? Patricia, we're looking for the lowest beef grading. Gary says it's standard. Do you agree or disagree with Gary?
I disagree.
You disagree also. All by yourself, Gary. $50, though, for your team, if you're right. Let's find out if you can do it. How about it? Is it standard? No, it is not. Judy, rightly so. You disagreed. So what do you think is the right answer?
I'll say commercial.
Commercial, you say. Patricia, you also disagreed. She says it's commercial. Do you agree or disagree with her?
I say selected.
So you disagree with her, and you say it's selected. Let's go to Judy first. For $50 for the juniors, is it commercial? Not. Okay, one more chance here. Patricia, cross your fingers. Hang on. $50 again if it's selected. The lowest grade of beef is called canner. No money there. Juniors, big sigh. And let's go right to our juniors now because the category is chaplain. The question is for Laura. Here it is. In 1940, Charlie Chaplin brilliantly satirized Adolf Hitler in his film The Great Dictator. What was the name of the tyrant played by Chaplin? Was it Benito Mussolini, Adenoid Hinkle, Stalin Leninsky, or Hans Heil? What do you think, Laura?
I'll say Hans Heil.
Hans Heil. Shirley, agree or disagree?
I'll agree.
You agree. Tom.
I'm going to agree.
You agree also. All or nothing at all for our juniors. For $200 was the name of Charlie Chaplin's tyrant, Hans Heil. No. Adenoid Hinkle was the name. No money there. You've got $75, juniors. Seniors, you have $275. And The goal is to get to $1,000. The way we reach that goal is by playing our $1,000 trivia race, which we will do when we come back right after this. Welcome back to Trivia Trap. $75 for our juniors, $275 for our seniors. The goal is $1,000. And the way we reach that goal is by playing our $1,000 trivia race. So come on, let's do that now. We're going to play our trivia race until one of our teams reaches $1,000. The winners will then get a shot at $10,000. Now, as you can tell over there, our seniors are out in front. That means they get to go first. Now, seniors, your team will have three chances to come up with the correct answer. If all three of you miss, control will then go over to the other side. And remember, each question is worth $100. However, after the 10th question, the values then double. They're worth $200 apiece. So here we go. The race is on. Seniors, salute, rock star or space? Which one, Patricia?
Space.
Space it is. In the U.S. manned space program, what was the name of the project that came between Mercury and Apollo? Gary.
Gemini.
Yes, it was Gemini. All right, Judy.
White House.
Seniors, who was the first president to live in the White House?
Abraham Lincoln.
No, Patricia.
Washington.
I'm sorry, Gary.
Adams.
Yes, John Adams. Very good indeed. Judy.
Name.
What's the name of the Mogwai, the good gremlin, bought by Hoyt Axton in the 1984 movie Gremlins?
Gremlin.
No, Patricia.
Oh.
Gary?
Rocky.
No. His name is Gizmo. Yay, you knew that. You're frozen at 475. All right, juniors, come on now. Here we go, Tom.
Cartoons.
Cartoons, good one. In the Hanna-Barbera cartoons, who was Hokey Wolf's companion? Laurie?
Fred Flintstone.
Oh, Shirley.
Barney Rubble.
No. Ding-a-ling is Hokey Wolf's companion. You're frozen at 75. Back to the seniors. Judy, pick one.
Salute.
Okay. The President of the United States rates a 21-gun salute. How many does the Vice President get?
None.
Incorrect. Patricia?
8.
No, I'm sorry. Gary?
12.
No. Vice President gets 19. You're frozen at 475. Come on, Tom. Let's go again.
Rock star.
Okay. Rock star. What famous rock star sang The Little Drummer Boy with Bing Crosby? Laurie.
Danny Kaye.
No, Shirley.
Mick Jagger.
Incorrect. David Bowie. You're frozen at 75. Again, the seniors. Judy.
Game shows.
My kind of category. Who was the original host of the radio series Take It or Leave It?
Art Linklater?
No, Patricia?
Bob Dale.
Incorrect, Gary?
Jack Benny?
No. Bob Hawke was his name. 475 again, juniors. Come on, Tom.
TV doctor.
TV doc. On Star Trek, the ship's doctors referred to as Bones McCoy. What's his real name? Laurie.
Leonard Nimoy.
What'd you say? I'm sorry.
Leonard Nimoy.
The answer is Leonard. Do you take that, judges? Justice Leonard? She said, Leonard, you will not throw the question away and go on to the next question. Is that correct? All right, fine. Shirley, pick one.
Soap opera.
Soap opera. Here it is. What soap opera featured Christopher Reeve as Ben Harper?
Young and Restless.
No. Tom?
Days of Our Lives.
Incorrect. Laurie?
One Life to Live.
No. Love of Life was the answer we were looking for. I'm sorry. Close. Not there. You're frozen at 75. Again, we go to the seniors. Judy?
Father.
Father. All right. What rock star is the father of Moon Unit? Patricia?
Nina.
Gary?
Zappa.
Yes, Frank Zappa. Oh. All right, Judy again.
Girlfriend.
Here it is. Pinky Tuscadero was the girlfriend of what TV character? Don't know.
Fonzie.
Yes, it's the Fonz. All right. That was our 10th question. Hereafter, values double. They're now worth $200 apiece. Gary, pick a question.
I'm going to try state.
In what state would you find Old Faithful?
Wyoming.
That's right, Wyoming. Good for you. Just in time. Judy.
M.
M for the game and a chance to play for $10,000. In Roman numerals, what does M stand for?
100.
Incorrect. Patricia?
10.
Incorrect. Gary?
1,000.
Yeah, that's it. 1,000. The seniors are the winners. gone. Never really got going that time. Tom, thank you. Nice to have you with us on our show. Sorry, you're a pretty lady. Nice to have you with us. Surely good luck to you. We're glad you're with us. Thank you very much, juniors. All right. Our winners are the seniors, the new champions. In a moment, they'll begin their climb up the trivia ladder for a pot of gold of $10,000. We'll be right back for that. Whoa. Champions, and here they are. Seniors, come in here. Judy, Patricia, and Gary are new champions. Congratulations to you. Let's find out a little bit quickly about you. What do you do, Judy?
I have a silk floral design shop.
Wonderful. How about you, Patricia?
I'm a travel agent.
All right. And Gary?
I'm a video promoter and a freelance writer.
And you also know a lot of trivia, I will tell you that. Congratulations to you. You're the new champions. Now I want to see you win $10,000. Go over there and get in position. Here we go. Up until now, you played as partners. You're now on your own. Your positions over there have been determined by how well you did in our trivia race. And Gary, you're in the number one spot. That means that you have the first option to play or pass on the first set of answers. So if you're ready, seniors, let's begin the climb. At the top of the ladder, $10,000. Gary, take a look. These are the first answers. As Boy George, as Dracula, as Tina Turner, as a gorilla. What do you think, Gary?
I'm going to pass.
Pass those to Patricia. Pat, you have the same option. You can play or pass.
I'll take it.
Take it. The question is yours. If you get it right, it's $1,000 added to your total, plus a chance to play for the big money. Here's the question. When Elton John performed in New York City on his recent tour, how was he dressed? I need the correct answer, please.
Gorilla.
As a gorilla. Let's see. For $1,000, was Elton John dressed as a gorilla? No, he was dressed as Tina Turner. Patricia, we say goodbye to you for today. You'll be back next time, though, with your team to defend your trivia crown. Thank you. Okay. Did you know the answer that time, Gary?
Yeah, I did.
You knew it, huh? Okay, let's go to the next level of our ladder. Take a look at these, Gary. You have to make the same choice, either to play or pass. New York City. London, Hong Kong, Paris.
I'll pass that too.
Pass those to Judy? All right, Judy, they're yours for $1,000 and a chance to go to the top of the ladder. Which of these cities was the first in the world to have a population of 1 million people?
London.
London, you say. Audience goes, oh. For $1,000 for Judy is the city that first hit the million mark, London. Congratulations to you. Very good. All right, Gary, so far you've passed two. You got to play this time. Let's go to the next level of the ladder, and these are your answers. Jerry Falwell, Jesse Jackson, Billy Graham, Oral Roberts. Here's your question. What religious leader recently hosted Saturday Night Live?
Jesse Jackson.
Jesse Jackson. $4,000 and the chance to join Judy at the top of the ladder is a Jesse Jackson. Of course. Good for you. Congratulations to you. You have now each earned the right to go to the top to play for $10,000. You automatically have the $1,000 when you got those correct. So good luck. Here we go to the final level of our ladder. There's a big pot of gold. One of you, maybe both. Theodore Roosevelt, Henry Ford, Al Jolson, Babe Ruth. Who coined the advertising slogan used by Maxwell House Coffee, good to the last drop? Now, if you would please raise the covers in front of you and record your choice. Who coined the advertising slogan used by Maxwell House Coffee, good to the last drop? Lock in your answers if you would please. You've done so. Gary, who'd you say?
I said Babe Ruth.
Babe Ruth. Judy, who'd you say?
I said Henry Ford.
You said Henry Ford. One of you may win $10,000. Let's find out. For Gary, and $10,000, was it Babe Ruth? No, it was not. Oh, Judy, it's nervous time now. You said Henry Ford, didn't you? Let's find out. For all the money, is it Henry Ford? No. Theodore Roosevelt. Roosevelt. The slogan was first used in advertisements shortly after Roosevelt's presidency. In the original ad, Roosevelt's name was mentioned. He's the one that said, good to the last drop. You didn't get the big money today. You'll be back tomorrow, as you know, to try it all over again. And we'll be back in just a moment to tell you about tomorrow's show. Welcome back to Trivia Trap. I really wanted you to hit the big money today. I know, but do not be discouraged because you'll have a chance to do it again tomorrow. Tomorrow, a new set of juniors will be competing against you. Hope you'll be there, too. Until then, I'm Bob Eubanks for all the gang at Trivia Trap saying so long, everybody. We'll see you next time. Bye-bye.
Men, such simple creatures. So vain.
You're very kind. Thank you.
Insecure.
Silence, I am in control.
Always needing approval.
I didn't get my third kiss.
And affection.
Just where I like to be, between two beautiful women.
Trying to show how smart they are.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to recite the Gettysburg Address.
Electricity and magnetism. I'm lost now.
No wonder we can't get enough of them. The Men from GSN. Tomorrow, starting at 9, 8 Central on GSN.